I was born in 1930 here in Omaha, Nebraska, during the stock market crash. I had a lot of energy as a kid. I've always been competitive.
I knew I was going to be interested in stocks the rest of my life, but probably at the time I was, you know, 8 or 9. I used to keep charts on all kinds of stocks when I was that age.
I found something early that turned me on.
You don't want to take a job just for the money. You don't want to take a job for an organization that you really don't feel good about, or work for people that you don't feel good about. You really want to be excited when you get out of bed every morning. And it won't necessarily be the job that you have 10 years later, but you'll be learning so much as you go along. And, you know, I took a job with Ben Graham, my hero. You know, I never asked the salary, and I found at the end of the month when I got my first paycheck what I was earning, because I just knew it was the right thing to be.
Advice I would give is to read everything in sight, you know, and to start very young. It's a huge advantage in almost any field.
By far the best investment you can make is in yourself. For example, communication skill. If they just learn to communicate better, both in writing and in person, they increase their value at least 50%. That's relatively easy. I did it myself. If you invest in yourself, nobody can take it away from you. The most important thing is really who you associate with. You want to associate with people that are better than you are. I mean, basically, you'll go in the direction of the people that you associate with, and you want to have the right heroes. If you want to emulate somebody, you better pick very carefully who you want to emulate.
The triumphs in life are partly triumphs because you know that everything isn't going to be a triumph. I would never get too hung up on mistakes. I know a lot of people that really agonize over them, and it just isn't worth it. I mean, tomorrow's another day, and you live it forward and just go on to the next thing.